Hi, I'm Lim, over here, okay? So today we are going to introduce one power supply. This is come to my recommendation. And the current maximum can be 5A, okay? This is really important part that if you want to fix some short in, let's say bigger logic board, let's say it is the iPad Pro or the big logic board, sometimes when the big logic board gets short, if you inject the voltage, you're burning until 2A or 3A, you're still unable to see any heat from thermal camera. That's why you need to have a bigger limit, at least 4A, 5A, you know. When you reach 4A or 5A, the place gets short, it should be hot enough to let the thermal camera to be detected, okay, in the big logic board. Okay, now begin to turn on. As we can see, there's another meter in here that we can see the charging flow. Okay, so the speed of maximum charging flow is 2A. So I will try and charge with it. It's charged with iPhone 7 here. So it is about 1.2. Okay, so not bad. At least we can know whether the phone can be charged or not. Okay. So, and you will see there's another USB port in here. Actually, this USB port is adjustable power, you know. It's adjustable power from here. This one is fixed 5W. This one is depends on what you put in, you know. Okay, I will show you how to use this one. If you have that kind of cable, this kind. Okay. The cable that come with charging FPC, okay. Usually, this cable is from Qianli, you know. You can use this to turn on the device, you know. So let me make an example here. Normally, after we plug in the cable, we need to press the power button, okay. So if you have this kind of cable, you don't need to press the power button to turn it on. So now I give about 4.0 voltage, and I press the power button from here instead of here. Okay, so press it. So and then you will see the current flow. Okay, this is considered self-testing. Okay, so just press it lightly one time. So you will see it load about 100 mA and then it drop back, okay. So, okay. So let me try again, give about 4.0 and press it one time. So 100 mA drop back to zero. So this is how we test the current problem. So if you press it second time, it should be turned on. So now the phone is turning on. And there's a, by the way, why I suggest this kind of power supply, not because it has a function like this, you know. It's because I need this. There's a 3 value digit behind the dot, okay? Because let's say if I have a specific CPU problem or wheel problem, okay, when I press the power button, it only have a, if your power supply is only have these 3 digits, no matter how many in front, it doesn't matter already, okay. It show you 0.02 20 mA. You can only know it is 20 mA, you know. There's a difference between 28 mA or 20 mA, you know. That's a big difference. Okay, by that I can already guess is whether the CPU not working or the CPU, some of the CPU coin is not giving enough power to the CPU, you know. The minor difference we need. But of course this one is every school is not same. You have to do your own database, you know. We have our own database with specific cable, specific power supply for the reading. Okay, you just refer to the reading and it can help you to diagnosis. And the point of this power supply, not only have digital, also have an analog, two in one, okay? Because why I still need to look at this, I already have this. The weakness of digital power supply is always like this, you know. It show you, okay, when I turn on, or when I'm loading, it show, okay, 0.200, and then 0.800, like this. If you have an analog, you can already see how fast he raised to the 200. How fast before he load to the 0.800. So you can see there's a details in the needle, you know. Because digital value is appealing, skip a lot of details. And the other is work as normal. Okay, we are very rare to use this function because we already have a multimeter to do this kind of job to test the power. Okay, we just need output, the reading output. And you will see there's another DC power 9 watt in here. So the whole thing is actually is DC. So 9 watt in here is for actually is for that kind of battery, you know, the square battery, a 9 watt battery, or maybe it's for your multimeter. Okay. Now I'm gonna do some tests. There's a few iPhone 10 logic board. So the third one is without CPU, none, okay? And this one is ready for transplant, okay? I will swap the CPU to here and then, yeah, blah, blah, blah. But every time we prepare the board, we need to know whether the power IC is working or not. We have a way to check like this. Okay. Plug in the power cable, okay? Once the voltage is reached to a certain value, you will see there's a little movement in the analog meter, okay? But in this kind of digital power supply, it's obvious it will have a value in behind, okay? So let's give it about battery voltage. So you see, it dropped back. It have a value and dropped back. The current is already under the power IC, okay? So every time if your power IC is working, it should be react like this without CPU and none. Okay, like this. I will repeat again. See, that's why sometimes it's really hard to see in the analog meter because the movement is too low. Okay, you see, movement is too low. So this one is quite obvious. The second method of checking the power IC without the CPU, none. So just now I say the first scenario, it would be the first response, it would be have a current flow in and then it drop back. Okay, this is the first symptom the power IC is working. So the second is you will get the 1.8 power in the power button, okay? And then in order to test whether the power IC is still functioning, we can press the power button without the CPU also, okay? You will see there's a small current. It will start in a small current. So if I press it, you see? There's a small response if I press it. So let's do again. See, every time I press it, it will flow. See, now I don't touch it, now I touch it. Okay, so this is how we test. It will attempt to boot on, but without a CPU, of course, it doesn't react anything at all. We can still notice the difference from the current drawing. Okay, so this is another way to check it. If let's say you have a doubt about the power IC installing without the CPU, you can do this. If you want to try, look at the analog, it's really hard to notice a difference. Unless your meter is come with a switch that you can see below 300 mA, the range, okay? So I will show you the picture in here. and you will see it can switch, so then he can show you the analog of under 300 mA. If that kind of multimeter, that kind you can see the small response. Okay. So if now we look at the analog meter, we press the power button. See, is it really, really hard to see the difference? If I zoom in, if you don't look at the digital, it's really hard to notice the difference. See, now I keep pressing, it will just flowing. So this is the reason. Okay, this is kind of the power supply that repaired the laptop. So as you can see, it can go to 30 volt 5A. Okay, I don't use this a lot because I don't repair the laptops, and some more, this machine have a one weakness, okay, that I don't like. It does come with the three value behind the dot, but every time you need to adjust the voltage, you need to press this button. You know, this button is on and off, you know, so means when doing the output, you cannot adjust anything. You can only adjust when you turn off the output and then you change like this. So it's not convenient, you know, especially if I want to do the blinking technique, such as high low like that, I cannot do, you know. So that's why I don't often to use this one. So let's talk about the difference between the analog and the digital power supply, okay? I still prefer analog power supply because I still can see the response from 0 to 1000, the motion, how fast is it, so where it stops, and then it goes, you know, it is quite obvious, you know. So some of the digital power supply, it will skip, you know, it will just show you 0 and then to 1000. Like this, so he will skip the 500 600 700. It may only show to 0 800 1000, so he will be skipping like that by looking how fast the needle rise or drop. I can notice some of the unusual activity, so this is why I still prefer the analog. And second thing is, when I do the blinking technique, okay, I can see how fast the needle raise, so I can stop it more faster than the digital power supply. Okay, then what about digital power supply? Okay, digital power supply, I'm not talking the expensive one, okay, I'm talking this kind. Let's say iPhone logic board, you press the power button one time, he will do some kind of self-testing, you know, from 0 to 80 mA and then drop back. If you hold it for more than a few seconds, it will start to turn on, but the first motion is still like this. So in this kind of testing mode, we can also tell anything unusual about this logic board. Some of the school, they're building a database for themselves, you know. So what do I mean is, they are building the current response, you know. Okay, this is the CPU problem, this is the RAM problem, this is the CPU voltage not enough, and SoC is not working. So they are building a lot of this kind of current response based on the digital power supply. I believe most of you can guess what I am explaining, you know. This is why I recommended this kind of power supply. It is a 2-in-1, you know. I can see how the analog meter reacting. I also can read the small current. So this is the reason this power supply can be satisfied all our need to repair the iPhone logic board and iPad, but not enough for repairing the laptop. So that's it for the sharing. See you guys next time.